before moving to the term breach of contract, we can say in general terms, the contract means legally binding agreement reached between the two partners, and it should contain terms over which courts have the authority and obligation to enforce. According to ICA 1872 2 H, a contract is an agreement enforceable by law. An agreement becomes a contract only when it is intended to meet its legal obligation, prepared on the basis of equality, mutual benefit, be in line with the applicable law. So each contract is unique. It's not like that every contract is same. Like I have my contract with different rules and regulations, with different norms, another one's contract, that will be different. That's why I say that each contract is unique. To feel that we are within a contract, we must be sure that we have understood the contract. So breach of contract, a contract is breached or broken when any of the parties fails or refuses to perform its promise under the contract. Breach of contract is a legal cause of action in which a binding agreement is not honored by one or more parties, by non-performance of its promises, by him or renders impossible. So Section 37 of Indian Contract Act 1872 provides that parties to the contract are under the obligation to perform or offer to perform their respective promises under the contract unless such performance is dispensed with or excused under the provisions of ICA or any of other law. So according to Section 39, where the party has refused to perform or disabled himself from performing his promise, it is entirely the other party may put an end to the contract unless that other party has expressly or impliedly signified its consent for the continuance of the contract. Then you can also say that if other party chooses to put an end to a contract, the contract is said to be broken and amounts to breach of contract by the party not performing or refusing to perform its promise under the contract, which is also called as in repudiation. So hence, repudiation can occur when either party refuses to perform his part or makes it impossible for him to perform his part of contract in each of the cases in such a manner as to show an intention not to fulfill his part of the contract. So a breach of contract is a failure. First of all, go through this meaning, then we'll move to the next, the breach of contract. In a layman language, you can say breach of contract, it's the non-fulfillment of the contract, whether partially or whether wholly. So next comes the various, various types of breach of contract. But if we talk about mainly, there is the anticipatory breach of contract and the actual breach of contract. So talking about the anticipatory breach of contract, so a breach is a failure by a party to fulfill the obligations under the contract. It is of two types, which is anticipatory and actual. Then talking about the anticipatory, from the name, anticipatory, it's a breach of contract which is being done before the time of the performance. So if a promiser denies to perform his promise and signifies his unwillingness before the time, like date is for October 20th, and the contract between the two parties, one person, the promiser, denies to perform his promise, that is called an anticipatory breach of contract when the contract is being ended before the time of the performance. The promiser can convey his unwillingness either expressing his word, whether the written or by speaking, or implying it by his conduct. So you'll be able to understand the anticipatory breach of contract. So this example, suppose Peter, who enters into the contract with John on May 30th. In this contract, Peter agrees to sell his house to John, provided he receives a token of amount of these 5 lakhs from John on or before June 30th. However, on June 15th, John informs Peter that he will not be able to provide the amount on the said date, thereby expressing rejection of the contract. Although the date was for June 30th, but before 15 days, he denied to perform his contract. That is called as anticipatory breach of contract. And in other examples, so Peter enters into a contract on June 1, 2018. As per the contract, Peter agrees to sell his guitar to John on June 10 for an amount of rupees 5,000. He sells his guitar to Oliver on June 7. Hence, it is an anticipatory breach of contract due to Peter's conduct. First one was the example of expressing it in the words, which was the spoken or written. Second, that he already sold to anyone else before the date, that is implying it by his conduct, by his action. This is the anticipatory breach of contract. So the anticipatory breach of contract is specified under section 32 of ICA 1872. It states, when a party to a contract has refused to perform or disabled himself from performing his promise in its entirety, the promisee may put an end to the contract unless he has signified but words or conduct his acquiescence in its continuance. Which means that he says the anticipatory breach of contract, according to section 39, he states that when any of the parties from the two parties refuse to perform or proves himself disabled from performing that promise, that is called as a breach of contract. So when a promiser refuses to perform his promise, leading to an anticipatory breach of contract, the promisee is excused from performance or from further performance of his obligations. Also, it can be either treat the contract as cancelled or file a suit against the other party for damages arising from the breach. So this suit can be filed immediately without waiting until the date of performance specified in the contract. Or you should choose not to cancel the contract, but treat it as an operative and wait until the time of performance has passed before the holding the other party responsible for the damages caused due to non-performance. However, you will need to keep the contract alive for the benefit of the parties involved. So go through the anticipatory breach. If you have doubt, let me know, then we'll move to the actual breach of contract. Read it very fast.
मैम
हेलो
यस मैम इन द फर्स्ट एग्जांपल व्हेन जॉन इन्फॉर्म पीटर दैट ही विल नॉट बी एबल टू प्रोवाइड द टोकन अमाउंट देन पीटर विल गिव अ होल अमाउंट ऑफ 5 लाख टू जॉन और ही विल डिडक्ट सम अमाउंट
See, it depends upon the remedy. After this type, we will be doing remedies. See, these are the remedies. Like these are the certain remedies through which the breach of contract should be, you know, avoided. That will be do is the remedy for this part in the anticipatory. It's just a type of the breach of contract. It says like I contracted with you, like I want to sell my car to you at rupees 5 lakh on October 20th. But on October 10th, I came to you and I said you verbally that I don't want to sell my car. Fine. In that case, you have full right either to compensate from me, whether the amount, or you have the right to file a suit against me. Fine. That is dependent upon the remedies that will be doing. There are certain remedies that how these things will be conducted further.
And same will be applied for the second example also.
Exactly. In that case, because before it, the time was for October 20th, but before, you know, informing you or informing to anyone else, that was a illegal aspect. That was not good aspect. Like I promised with you, but I contracted with someone else. Again, in that case, you have the right either to file the suit against me. Here, you can see. This suit can be filed immediately without waiting until the date of the performance specified in the contract. In case after 20th, October 20th, you come to me that I want to file a suit against you, that will not be benefited. You have
Yes, ma'am, but for suing to the other party, what is the date? Like before the contract ending or before till, contract ending?
Till that day, October 20th.
Okay. Fine.
On or before, not after.
Not after ending the contract?
No.
Okay.
Fine. You should like file it immediately without waiting, because you can't wait. Like whenever you notice that this thing is going to happen, suit the case. File the case immediately before, without waiting until the date of the performance specified in the contract. Fine. And provided you should not cancel the contract if you want to get some benefit from that contract.
Okay.
You should treat it as an operative one, that this is being going on and I have the right to, you know,
file a case against the other party.
Fine.
Okay.
So next is the actual breach of contract. So while an anticipatory breach is before the time, an actual breach is on the scheduled time of performance, the date on which contract is to be done. So an actual breach of contract can be committed either at the time when the performance of the contract is due. For example, Peter enters into contract with John promising to deliver 50 bags of cotton to him on June 30th, 2018. However, on the scheduled day, he fails to deliver the same. This is an actual breach of contract. Also, this breach is at the time of performance of the contract is due. During the performance of a contract, so it can also occur when one party fails to perform his obligation during the performance of the contract. This refusal can be expressed in the words or by action. So that is called an actual breach of contract. So apart from this, we have two more breaches, you know, which that is just for your general knowledge, which is the material breach of contract and the minor breach of contract. So if I talk about the material breach of contract, so it occurs when party receives significantly less benefit or significantly different result than what was specified in the contract. So material breaches, material, that's the word which is related with the money, which is related with the benefit. So it can include a failure to perform the obligations laid out with the contract. Or you can also say that it's a failure to perform contracted obligations on time. So like you can analyze that when a material breach occurs, the other party may have the right to pursue damages to related to breach, and both it directly and indirectly. And if I talk about the minor breach, minor, the small, the partial. So it's minor to minor, we can also say it's a partial breach of contract. So it refers to the situation where the deliverable of the contract was ultimately received by the other party. For example, you like provided the goods to me, the contract was between us, but that was ultimately received by some other party. But the party in the breach failed to fulfill some part of the obligation. In such cases, the party that suffered the breach may only be able to pursue a legal remedy if they can prove that the breach resulted in the financial loss. A late delivery, for example, may not have the remedy if the breached party cannot show the delay resulted in the financial consequences. So this was the material and the minor breach. Material, which is related with the money, with the benefit, who has the right to get the part. You have the, it occurs when the other party may pursue some damages related to the breach, whether it's directly or indirectly. And if I talk about the partial or minor breach, that is called a partial breach by mistake or by, you know, intentionally, the goods is being received by some other party. In that case, it is delayed in the performance of the contract. During the performance of the contract, there was some, you know, negligence. And in that case, I have for the late delivery, like this remedy, if the that the breach one party cannot show that delay resulted in financial consequences. So go through this actual breach.
Ma'am, both 1 and 2 are quite similar. What is the difference between them? Excuse me, ma'am.
So before moving to the remedies, I'll just show you a short video regarding the breach of contract.
Part of the contract, so it's not able to make this.
So here he is denying. Why? Because in the contract it was written that these things should be mentioned. So that was it. Before the time, she said that if you will not be able to do the task the way I am telling you, anticipatory breach of contract will be done. So what he's saying, so Cathay Pacific Airways Limited, that's the case, a failure without the legal reason to comply with the terms of a contract. It is not punishable by imprisonment because it is not a crime. So it is only a civil case. However, you will have to deal with the consequences, hence be liable for the damages. Why is it not punishable? Because it's not a legal act. You can still have a right to get, you know, to file a suit against the person regarding the damages occurred, regarding the compensation to get by him. But it is not like that, that if there is a breach of contract, cancellation of the contract between the parties, no imprisonment will be given because it is not a crime. You are liable for the damages, but it is not an imprisonment act. So like if there is a contract between the two friends, they are very good friends. Due to breach of contract, it is not a good idea. Why? Because if any of the friends fail to perform the party, it could affect their relationship and trust in the future. that is all about the breach of contract, that how, what exactly it's a breach of contract, how we should conduct them, and remedies. Now we're going to do remedies now. So next comes the remedies, that what are the remedies for breach of the contract. So the Indian contract act lays out the provisions for the performance of the contract. It also contains the provisions in case of breach of contract by either party. So let us take a detailed view at the available remedies for breach of contract. So when a promise or agreement is broken by any of the party, we called it as a breach. So when either of the parties does not keep their end to an agreement or does not fulfill their obligation as per the terms of the contract, it is the breach of contract. There are the few remedies which are available for the breach of the contract to the wrong party, which is rescission of contract. So when anyone of the party to a contract does not fulfill the obligations, then the other party can rescind the contract and refuse the performance of the contract and its obligations. As per Section 65 of ICA, the party that rescinds the contract must restore any benefits he got under the said agreement. And Section 75 states that the party that rescinds the contract is entitled to receive damages or compensation for such a reason. So, which is called as a rescission of the contract. For example, you can say it's an unwinding contract, you can say. Can anyone quote an example for rescission of a contract?
When the other party fails to perform, आपने जो लास्ट एग्जांपल दिया था, लाइक मैं आपको स्कूटी
ट्राई टू टेल इट इन इंग्लिश
लाइक व्हेन आई प्रॉमिस्ड यू टू सेल माय स्कूटी फॉर 10,000 एंड I have sold to the other party without informing you, then you can recede on that.
Which is like that should be by the mutual agreement.
Between mutual agreement. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Good. Anyone else? So next is the sue for damages. So Section 73 clearly states that the party who has suffered, like I am the party, I have suffered, since the other party has broken the promises, can claim compensation for loss or damages caused to them in the normal course of business. So such damages will not be payable if the loss is abnormal in nature, that is not an ordinarily course of business. There are two types of damages according to the Contract Act. One is the liquidated, another one is the unliquidated. If I talk about the liquidated damage, like when you can say sometimes the party of a contract would agree to the amount payable in the case of breach of contract. Like I told you that I want to sell my bike at rupees 1 lakh. But before the due date, I said that I don't want to sell that. In that case, I will say that I will, you know, compensate you regarding the thing. I'll give 10,000 rupees as a refundable amount. You can take it and we can finish up this contract. Like I am paying some amount to you to close that contract. But that should be again mutually between the both, and unliquidated damages. So here the amount payable due to the breach of contract is assessed by the court or by any appropriate authority. So in unliquidated, that, you know, it will be properly legally won. Like if both of us want to mutually compensate on that case, that should be assessed by the court first or the appropriate authority, the third party or who has witnessed it, that should be done. Then sue for specific performance. So this means that party in breach will actually have to carry out its duties according to the contract. In the video, we have just that swimming in that swimming pool, Meg swimming pool video. This was the specific contract. The example they did, the remedy they used between the both the person who was hired for making the swimming pool and the Meg swimming pool. They what remedy did they use? There's the specific performance. So in certain case, the court may insist that party carry out the agreement. So if any of the party fails to perform the contract, the court may order them to do so. She said, like, if you will not be able to complete my task, to complete my work, I will hire a court, the third party. Court will assess you and he will order you to make the swimming pool before the due date. So this is a decree of specific performance and is granted instead of damages. For example, I decided to buy a parcel of land from you. You refuse to sell. Then the court can order you to perform your duty under the contract and sell that parcel of land to me. That is the sue for specific performance. Then injunction. So injunction is basically like a decree of specific performance, but for a negative contract. So an injunction, it's a court order restraining a person from doing a particular act. So court may grant an injunction to stop a party of contract from doing something he promised not to do. In a prohibitory injunction, the court stops the commission of an act, and it's a mandatory injunction. It will stop the continuance of an act that is unlawful. So it's a, you can simply in the layman language, it's a court order stating that a company must do something or cease from doing the certain act. If I take an example, so an industrial plant dumping waste into lake may be served as an injunction to stop that particular activity by the court order. Go through these two. And the last, if I talk about the quantum merit, you can say it's a very reasonable sum of money to be paid for the services rendered or work done when the amount due is not stipulated in a legally enforceable contract. So it literally translates as much is earned. So at times, when one party of the contract is prevented from finishing his performance of contract by the other party, he can claim quantum merit. So he must be paid a reasonable remuneration for the part he has already performed. This could be the remuneration of the service he has provided or the value of the work he has already done. So if I talk about the case for quantum merit, like I S, I, the daughter, S is the daughter, and M, you are the father. Both of us had an agreement where father asked the daughter to provide the medical care for him while he was sick. In return, father agreed not to write a will and agreed to give his estate to her daughter after he died with an intent to give her a fair portion for the services rendered. She promised that she will take proper care of him whenever the father is ill. For that case, the father, he promised that he will give a part portion of, he will give a fair, he'll give a property to her for the services being rendered by her. In that case, if the father soon died, leaving all the estates for his brother and nothing for his daughter, her father was unjustly enriched as he received the services, but in return, daughter received nothing. So if in this example, daughter seeks to recover a portion of father's estate by claiming the remedy of quantum marriage. Yes, Maya? Yes, Maya, please tell me your query.
Ma'am, in third one, when B refuses to sell his land to A, if B has refuses to sell his land because of any personal personal need, or
so in breach of contract, we did the meaning, the anticipatory and actual breach. Apart from this, we did material and minor breach. Then the remedies of the breach, the rescission of the contract when the contract is being rescinded. Sue for damages, you have to, the court has the right to sue the person for the damages. The sue for specific performance, court has to assess and accordingly they have to provide the specific performance. Injunction, a decree for specific performance, but for the negative contract. And quantum merit, a reasonable remuneration should be given to the person or the person who has spent any amount for that particular period of time, money should be given to that person. That is the quantum merit. So these are the remedies and breach of the contract. So with this, we'll end up today's topic.